Good evening, everybody. I'm delighted to be here, and I can't wait for it to begin, so I'm just going to sit down.
Thank you, Miss Young. Also in the studio here in the middle of London, a studio which... ...a word since. So, would the engineers work one of their routine miracles and put us in touch with the Strata Cruiser? While that is being achieved, just anything at all... Gilbert Harding.
Yes, we are here, still gaining height. I'm moving even further away from Leslie Piddington. And here is Jean Gordon, a stewardess. What did you do to Mrs. Piddington a few minutes ago?
I searched her very thoroughly in spite of the cold. I made her take off everything. I looked in the padding of her jackets. I looked in her boots. I even looked in her mouth and her hair. And now I have her handbag, so I think you can be sure she's nothing hidden away anywhere on her person.
Well, here we are still...
I think that's just about all we've got time for. Mr. Damani, would you please check those articles for this test, that is for the last part of this broadcast? I'm going to ask Mr. Perkins to nominate any two numbers, 1 and 150. In that way, two of the 150 numbered envelopes issued to you here will be indicated. Now, Mr. Perkins, will you call out two numbers between 1 and 150, and will the people who hold those envelopes pass them along towards the centre aisle, and I'll get Mr. Williams to go down and collect them and bring them back here on the platform.
You better hold them up so that Mr. Hugh Williams can see where they are, otherwise it's going to take some time.
Mr. Williams, would you give one to Miss Young and keep the other one yourself? Now, I want you to take any of the envelopes since I asked for messages or some other enclosure to be inserted.
Nope.
Then, in your opinion, could either I or Leslie have any idea of the nature of those enclosures which you hold and which were determined by numbers announced by Mr. Perkins?
No, not possibly.
It's interesting to point out, by the way, listeners, at this point, that Leslie, Sidney Piddington's wife, is really isolated in an aircraft some numbers of thousands of feet above Bristol. She's been there for hours.
Someone saying hello. Spirit. I can't make sense out of it. It's poetry. A cup.
Well, blithe spirit, Gilbert Harding, will you ask?
All right, concentrate again, would you, Sydney? It's not words this time. It's a drawing. A pattern. Draft board. Something it can't be. It's on paper. Or someone's given a crossword puzzle. It's half filled in. They haven't got all the words. You want me to give the words there are? Right, concentrate on the first one, will you? Something about cards. People playing cards. Shuffling. Shuffle, that's one. And cutting, just cut. I think the next one's a head, someone's head. Next one's about money. Some more. Hot. Something hot. It's something wet. hot. Dry. Drying? Drier. I would have gone to the next one.